Machine than it was the old one. But anyway, hello and welcome to the Daily Vlog. I'm Gary.
I'm Lael.
And we should have thought of a topic before we started. We should do the top 10 comedy movies of all time. The top 10 funniest movies of all time.
Top 10 suck.
Because
movies suck.
Deb and I were thinking about this the other day, and it really made me try to think. I mean, you know, comedies, movies that have made me laugh. And it seemed to me that it should be an obvious answer for what my funniest movies of all time were. But it took me a little while.
It's not obvious. It's not at all obvious.
It was obvious. It took me about 10 minutes, and then okay. I realized, oh, duh. Oh. Of course. But I won't get to those quite yet.
Okay.
Because they were like, oh, duh, of course those are the funniest movies. There's two of them, actually. But but then, you know, I started thinking about just general, you know, comedies and stuff. I mean, I there's plenty of movies that I laugh at, but they're not necessarily, like, comedy isn't their main thing. There's more. There's story. There's drama. Big Lebowski's, like, my favorite movie, and it's very funny, but...
It's not really a comedy.
It's not like it's not like a lot of the stuff in there I just think is really cool, not that it's funny. Like, I've had a lot of fun.
Did you go see it at Red Rocks this week? They had
Yeah, they do it once a year.
I was wondering if you were going to do
no,
that.
No, the kid, you know. Yeah. But, it's obviously like the movie Airplane came to mind as having to be on the top 10.
You know, when you say that, I just think of the giant floaty thing and everybody going down the giant, like, that's my memory, because you remember Airplane came out in like 82.
I remember the bullshit sign.
What's that?
I remember.
But I was very young, needless to say.
I'd say, like, the first National Lampoon Vacation is pretty funny. Maybe that.
Is that the one where they strap the granny to the top of the car?
Yes.
Okay. See, again, my memories of these are vague. They're, like, 20 years old.
Yeah. But, so many of the movies I like are dark humor. They're not, like, laugh out loud humor. Mm-hmm. So trying to, like, figure out, well, what would you think of your top?
Funny? I mean, I'm searching. Like, the movies that I tend to like are, like, really serious ones. Or...
It's just that big.
I really like serious... Like, Pulp Fiction's, like, probably my favorite movie of all time. And it's... I mean, it has funny moments, but again, not a comedy.
It's true, it's not really a comedy.
Stupid humor. Like, I don't really get in... Like, I'm not good at stupid humor. So, a lot of things like Jim Carrey movies and stuff like that, you know, or Will Ferrell, it's kind of lost.
I have to throw in, I'd say on the top 10 list, I think would be Duck Soup, Marx Brothers.
Yeah, I've never seen it.
And, I love Abbott and Costello, so maybe Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein. It usually is the
sounds
considered
funny.
To be the top one.
Also, I've never seen it.
And,
I'm worthless when it comes to talking about movies.
But I don't know.
I like kids' movies. Like, I love animated, like, features and Disney movies and stuff like that. Yeah. And I always enjoy watching those, but...
But anyway, it became obvious after a while, after I thought of it, that, of course, there's a movie and actually a pair of movies that are, like, by far the funniest and everything like that. And they are Monty Python and the Holy Grail and Monty Python and the Life of Brian.
What if I told you I've never seen either one?
Oh, jeez. Why do you even work here?
You should just fire me right now for that statement alone.
I think Life of Brian is really funny, but not as funny as the Holy Grail.
No, I put Holy Grail as number one, definitely. Life of Brian, though, I think the humor was a lot more... It's so good in Life of Brian. It's just a little more sophisticated, a little bit more social and political and all that, whereas Holy Grail's just... There's none of that baggage. It's just straight, you know, there.
Strange
but I have to... Life of Brian, number two, I think, easily.
A Strange Brew came
to
mind.
Now, there you go. I agree with you on that one. I love that.
That's a freaking hilarious movie.
I mean...
I love Canadians.
Yeah, but I don't know. You know, the whole idea of, like, two people sitting on a sofa, talking to a camera, being broadcast, you know, just a handful of people in the world... I mean, it was so unrealistic. Why would you have a show like that?
I don't know.
Why would anybody do a show like that?
It was like Wayne's World.
Yes, if you don't know, so before Wayne's World, there was a show called SCTV. Before Saturday Night Live, there was SCTV. Well, actually, not same time. But anyway, and it was Rick Moranis and Dave Thomas from SCTV, and they did a cable access show parody thing called Great White North. And it was these two Canadian guys, and they made fun of Canadians because they were Canadians. And had this little cable access show, and it was really funny, and it was such a big hit on SCTV that they actually made a movie. And the movie is called Strange Brew,
and they go to
a brewery. Hilarious.
Yeah.
Yes, it's hilarious.
It is. It's great.
And you'll find it's like 1980s.
What kind of name is Rick Moranis?
I don't know, but he certainly has had a massive career. Everybody from SCTV has had a huge career after that show. Nice. But anyway,
but he hasn't done anything recently.
He's done a lot.
What has he done?
Well, I don't know. But he's done a lot
over
the years.
Honey, I Shrunk
the
Kids. There you go.
Well,
movie.
Anyway. What are your funniest movies? Tell us at thedailyvlog.com. Bye.